Well, here's the day that I've been dreading slash anticipating for months now. The day that we arrive in Barcelona without a game plan, without a place to stay tonight, without much Spanish. And strangely enough, I feel very calm and relaxed about the whole thing. And looking forward to what kind of adventure we have in Barcelona. So we've cleared customs here in Barcelona.
Kaelin is now once again armed and dangerous. Sunghee's always armed and dangerous with a beautiful smile.
It's quite cool and overcast. It's really, quite frankly, a relief. They promised us rain, but right now it's dry. This is perfect.
We took a taxi from the cruise ship terminal, and he dropped us off here at this two-star hotel, about a 10-minute walk from La Rambla.
I guess we're kind of spoiled. The next two nights here are going to cost us 255 euros. It's a little bit humid, a little bit warm, kind of damp, smells of old socks. The floor is still wet because they just cleaned the room. And anyhow, we have internet here. We haven't tried it yet, but supposedly we have internet here. We will use that internet to try to find ourselves more affordable accommodations and figure out our next plan from here. We are on the hunt for a grocery store. What we found so far are a lot of convenience stores which carry the usual sort of assortment of snack foods and packaged processed foods, and there are some fruit and vegetable stands, but we have not found anything yet that sells something that we would recognize as groceries. Personally, I'm starving, so I hope we find something soon. So we spent several hours walking around downtown Barcelona. We ended up stopping at another cafe to eat. The baking was okay. The prices are fairly expensive. Now, if you go on in the back laneways, you can get food at better prices, and that's eventually what we did on our way back. We couldn't find any supermarkets that were open today, being a Sunday, just the little mini-marts, and they typically didn't have any good food. But in the back laneways, we came into the ethnic areas, primarily Muslim, and found a little mini-mart that had a surprising selection. While it's not gourmet, it should get us through the night. So look at that, some real dead animal for protein, and a little bit more. And real coconut milk. It's been weeks. We're thrilled to see this. And as well, some aloe vera to treat my burned collar, and some sunscreen to help prevent further damage. And just to celebrate it all, a can of San Miguel beer. Before we left, I made sure that we had everything set up so that we could be attached electronically to the world. And so we invested some money on adapters and converters, and here's what we got.
This is the converter. This is to use if you're using electronics that were designed for use in North America and you want to use them in Europe. Very, very simple. You plug your piece into here and you plug that into your European electrical outlet, and you'll be good to go. Only one little problem here.
Oh, doesn't quite reach. And I know what you're saying. Hey, dummy, use an adapter. Right you are.
This fits in here perfectly. Very nice. And now, uh-oh, little bit of a problem.
The guy at the travel store didn't warn me about that. But that's okay. Laptops these days don't actually need to have a converter. All you need is the adapter.
Problem is, it only stays connected if I hold it really tight. If I let it go,